Some wonderful houses around here. I spent the last 5 minutes standing back there in the street corner waiting for the traffic to die down, because as soon as I wanted to film, there were cars and delivery vans everywhere. And here's another one. And maybe a private road, but under the right to roam act, we're allowed to use it to access the trail, which is down the end there. I'm on a trail. I have been for the last 200 metres, but I couldn't film until now because there's a bloke mixing cement on that private road and he had a stereo blasting music out. And we all know how YouTube doesn't like us to play music. Especially my previous account got cancelled because of it. So I had to wait until I was far enough away that the camera doesn't pick it up. Last thing I want is a bloody copyright breach. There are so many trails here. This main one I'm on split off into three different ones down there. And now splitting off to that. And there's one up there. But I'm sticking with this one because I know I need to go down and across the road towards the stream that I crossed the last time. And instead of turning right and following it, I go straight ahead and up over the hill through the small township there and basically along there. So I'll see you guys shortly. Okay, that's the trail that I come down last time to these gates. Down here along the field and across the road. So I'll bring you guys back when I'm across and I'm by the stream. Through that gate and follow the trail. This time I'm going up the pathway here and around that manor house. So down there's the pathway that I'd normally be walking if I was heading east. And I've spotted a bloke down there fishing. If he's aware that it's not permitted. He could be owner, he could be the owner of the manor houses back here. Anyway, leave him to it. Wow. That's all I can say is wow. That is beautiful. Look, car coming. I've started a stampede. It's a large flock of, there's a large herd of young bulls over there. They've been following me along here. And all of a sudden they decided to run. They're in a playful mood, I'd say. Yes, I can see you. And there's a car coming. Parkfield Latimer. Right, I gotta check my map, see where I am. And this looks like a private estate. And yes, I'm on track. Private estate, no entry for anybody who doesn't live there, but right next to it there's a public footpath. And as long as you stay on the footpath, you're not in breach of trespassing laws. On the trail again, I can't wait to get it back on the trail again. Okay, there's a small deer up ahead. I think it's a deer. A monk jack. And it's heard me. Here's where I went under. You can see a distinct game trail there. And it goes right through. So I say that deer comes out here every day. And there's another one. Focus. I really want to go in there, and as soon as, ooh, there's one. I reckon I can get through there. It's probably private property, but I don't see any signs. Ouch, thorns. Alright. It's a little hidden gem. Try my best to walk where the game trail is. Wow. Well, that deer over there hasn't moved. We'll see if I can find her. There, she's still there watching me. And in here there's a pathway. So I know that the pathway over there follows a tree line, so I'll follow this for a bit. Oh, wouldn't you know it. There's an entry point just over there. It's just a sea of bluebells. Okay, that deer is still over there. Actually, she just ducked her head down. Come on. There she is. So that's where I came from. I ducked in, went through the woods, came out, and she hasn't budged. Is it a she or a he? Looks like it's got one antler. Yeah, that's a boy. Sorry, mate, I was calling you she. Before I go any further, I'm just going to have a bite to eat and some water. It's actually quite warm. Some of you may be thinking, he's doing a lot of track walking videos, like hiking videos. Well, it's basically because I'll do videos of what I can do at the time. And at the moment, I've got a lot of time on my hands because it is Thursday today, and didn't work on the Easter weekend, so that's why I was out walking. So Tuesday I went into work only to be told I'm not needed, because it's that quiet at the university that they didn't need any agency staff. So basically this entire week I've got it off, which is not good, because like everyone else I have bills to pay. I've got £120 bill to the shipping agency that's got to go to customs for clearance of all my property that's arrived. My phone is useless now because I ran out of credit yesterday and I haven't got any money to top it off. And when I say I don't have any money, I literally mean I don't have any money. Got a text message this morning from Vodafone saying they tried to take payment for my plan, but it wasn't successful. And also got a text message from the bank saying that I am overdrawn, and because I don't have an overdraft, I have until 3 p.m. this afternoon to put money back into my account to avoid a transaction fee or some whatever they call it. I'm behind on my rent by 1 week at this stage, and last week didn't get paid from work. Some friends came over from America and I took that week off because I had 35 hours of holiday accrued, so I put in for holiday leave, which is fine. But my manager also went away for the Easter weekend and she forgot to put my holiday pay in, so come the Friday, no money.
And I spoke to her yesterday. She's very apologetic and all that. So that doesn't fucking help me, does it? I'm behind my rent and all this sort of stuff because I'm not working that much. And I've applied for multiple jobs. Still to hear back from them. Went for a job interview yesterday. And I walked out. I'm not working for that mob. It's a mob called... This is just my personal opinion. I'm not saying that they do this, but this company called Wise Security, I Googled them to get their address to go for the interview, and read some reviews, and every review I read was bad. Late payment of wages. Wages paid by check. You're fined £35 if you show up late for a shift or if you don't turn up for a shift. What else? There was a couple other things. And every person that left a comment was an ex-staff member. There were three positive comments, and they were from management themselves, including the managing director. He even left a comment praising the company. And I know it's a managing director because when I found their website, I look into company's history and background before I apply for work with them. And lo and behold, there's a managing director, and his name matches the name in the review. So I had already booked the interview, so I went along anyway just to check him out. And the staff were rude when I got there. It was like a production line. Very bad atmosphere in the place. And after about 5 minutes, I just got up and left because they basically said, "You here for an interview?" I went, "Yep." Fill this paperwork out, put your identification details on the table. And then she walked off. Came back, grabbed the guy sitting next to me, grabbed his paperwork and walked off without telling him. He was going through his bag at the time, and she just walked up to the table and just grabbed his stuff and walked off. And when he looked back up again, he goes, "Where's my stuff gone?" And I told him. And he just looked at me and shook his head. So I was not going to hand my passport and bank details over to this mob. So I said, "Thank you for your time. I'm out of here." So I left. So at the moment, if I'm out hiking, because I just need to get out of the house, I'll film it. Flies are bad in here, probably because my tuna sandwich. Really nice here. Hold on, I'll turn the camera around if I can reach you guys. So the pathway which is on the map, which comes along next to this field, well, it meets up with the other pathway that runs through that pretty little bluebell wood. So I wonder where this one starts. Probably at that private residence back there. So I follow this until I get to a road where I cross over. Reserved rights, not open to the public. And somebody's vandalized the fence line. And I can see clear trails in there. It's bloody typical. Actually, I'm just wondering, should I grab that branch and put it across there? Well, there's no one here. Guarantee you, when I come back next time, that will be pulled down.
You know when you walk somewhere and you see something and you go, that looks familiar? Well, this little section of the woods with that field, it looks familiar. Now, years ago, when I was here last time, I used to catch a train out to Amersham and walk through the Amersham town and out the other side and follow the road down to a trail. And I think that's where I may be. I think Amersham may be on the other side of that hill. Because I used to go to Amersham, come down a hill, cross a stream where there's a zigzaggy road, and cross a field and walk up a trail into a section of wood where my friend and I used to dig up flintstone and just, you know, generally sort of hang out for the day and then walk back. I have a distinct feeling that this wood may be it. Because I caught a train to Chalfont Latimer, and I'm walking to Chesham. Now Chesham is north of Amersham. So if Chesham is that way, and that's south, Amersham will be there. So I think I'm done a complete loop back to where I was previously. And the last time I was here was probably 7 years ago. So it's amazing what the mind can remember. You see something and it sticks in your memory, and for some reason that bloody helicopter won't piss off. It's been buzzing around for the last 20 minutes. And this is a traffic helicopter. What's he doing out here? Oh, hang on. Maybe there's been traffic accident. Sorry, road collision. They don't call them traffic accidents because that implies that no one was at fault. You know, because I've been out here so often now, I've got this urge, real solid urge, to get out of London, just to relocate out to the countryside or a smaller town. I've even looked at places online. You know, I'm paying cheap rent for where I'm at. I'm only paying $350 a month for a room in Zone 2. So not Zone 2, Zone 4, but SE2, London. So I thought, I'll just hop on Google and have a look how much a rent is for rooms in other towns. And I found plenty of rooms, double-sized rooms, for the same price. The only thing I need to do is get my security license first. Or find a different type of job to get into. Once I've got a job and I'm working, then I can afford to move. But I can't afford to move until I've got a job here. So it's like a catch-22. I want to get out, but to get out I need to get a job to get the money to get out. But then when I relocate, I'm going to have to find another job all over again. So what do you think? Should I relocate? I mean, look at this. Get away from the big smoke and get back out into the countryside and live and work there, hopefully. Leave any ideas you have in the comments below.